part of it. Mm-hmm. It's for me to get to him, it's about, Pocatello. You know what Pocatello is in Idaho?
No.
It's right at the top. You know, Idaho is like this, right?
Yes, it is really narrow on the top.
Yeah, well, where the bend is here,
yep.
It's maybe 50 miles in silence.
Oh, okay.
So you go all of Montana,
yeah, yeah.
And then Pocatello, exit number 73.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, well, it's 73 miles inside the border.
Yeah, good man. Very good, thanks. Coffee, please.
Coffee with milk.
Okay.
So, yeah, 73 or 79. One
yeah,
or the other.
Yeah.
So it's not that far. But the thing is, you should try to tell us. I was going to call him.
Yeah.
See, I thought you were coming tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
I misread the thing yesterday.
Oh,
so
okay.
It matters now. So, because I wanted to get a hold of him
mm-hmm.
on Monday to see what he's up to.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right? So then we can arrange things. See,
I can touch them. What city is he going to?
Yeah. Where he's got the load to, and I have to leave on Wednesday.
Yeah, me too.
I cannot leave prior to that.
Yeah.
And I just told my wife, well, I'm leaving around 4 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, yeah.
So you're crazy.
What city in Idaho are you delivering to? JP wants to know.
Are you guys ready to order?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Okay, what are you going
to
have?
Hard to order. Let the man go first.
All right, we'll go with T-bone steak and eggs. Well done on the steak and over easy on the eggs.
Toast?
White.
I'm going to have two over easy sausages, hash browns,
Give me onions and and maybe give me an extra egg over easy as well.
Sure.
All right.
That was hard.
Thank you.
But anyway, no, that's the thing is, to me,
yeah.
It matters none. I can sit down there,
yeah.
Keep running, you freaking drive me up to go. Late at night to Spokane, let's say, from Idaho.
Yeah, exactly.
Right?
Yeah.
And it's not that far.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. And then from Spokane to Everett, it's only a 4.5-hour drive.
Oh, okay.
According to England.
Yeah, yeah.
Spokane to Seattle,
yeah.
448 miles. Oh, geez, I got a freaking mistake here. Oh, 0.9. And then 5-hour drive.
Okay, so that would be kilometers, not miles, right?
Yes, kilometers. Sorry, yeah, I converted it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I converted everything to kilometers.
Yeah, that's much better. That
Well, I don't have to screw around with it. But to me, and then I want to keep track of it. I like to mess around with
space. Yes, me too. Yeah, like I showed you guys on the video, my fuel up there, you know.
Yeah, well, that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to find out.
You know?
Oh yeah.
I just filled up here today, so that's what I did today.
6.88 miles.
That's US miles per gallon.
US miles.
Yeah.
So I bet my fan. 3.78 is Canadian.
No, that is US.
That is US.
Yeah. 4.55.
Oh yeah, 4.5. I didn't bring my I thought it was Sergey Drakchev, he always talks about 3.68.
Well, that must be US.
And 3.78.
Canadian miles. Or, Canadian gallons. Liter to Canadian.
Yeah.
Gallon to liter.
Compare it.
Imperial to liters. was 4, 5, 4, 6, 1.
4, 5, 6, 1.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And that's going with US. We can see the US as well.
Yeah.
So that is 37854. I knew it was 378.
Yeah, and the thing is, at 5, it's almost 2.79.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you do the carry.
Yeah, so if I go from US gallons to Imperial, and I have done 6.68, right? So 6.88. Oh, I see. Yeah, so that is 5. So that doesn't make sense. US, there should be more, not less.
Yeah.
It's showing me 5.72. That doesn't make sense.
Well, hang on. US gallons is smaller than Imperial gallon by 1 quart.
Yes, yeah, that's right. Yeah.
So it says 3.75 is the US gallon.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Compared
so
to, quarts.
Yeah.
Okay, 3.75 quarts is the US
gallon.
Okay,
so here it is. That makes sense. 8.26 Canadian miles per gallon.
Wow, that's
great. That's very good. Anything over 6.5 is usually good for me. See, I got, this is what I've done on average for this year.
Wow, yeah. Almost that. Yeah. See, my Jeep, that's what I've been looking on the internet,
yeah,
on this,
yeah,
thing. And it's a 2006 Jeep CRD diesel.
Yeah.
And oh, people are cursing them in the space.
Yeah.
They have to put additives to run it.
Really?
And they come up with names. I should write them down and ask you guys. You might know what they do. In Canada, I don't do nothing for it.
Yeah.
And I get sometimes, if I drive it nice.
Yeah.
If I'm not an asshole.
Yeah.
That thing's got kept, like, it's got picked up and put me down, like, right now.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. And if I drive it hard, I'll get 150 kilometers out of a tank of fuel.
Oh, wow.
And it's 75 liters. That's the catch.
Mm-hmm.
And if I take it nice and easy, I'll get 620, 630.
Yeah.
And the other day, I was at the garage, and I got all my receipts.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I keep all my receipts.
Yeah.
I put in, I think it's 72 liters.
Uh-huh.
And I thought, oh crap, that's what, no, I put 73 liters. I said, this thing was 72. So I went and checked it out. It's 75 point some liters.
Wow, so you had it almost dry.
Almost. And the thing is, then I read on the internet about this thing, and they're saying,
don't run it dry,
because it's a pain in the ass to
get it going, yeah.
Yeah. So, and that's why I'm going to Donette. I have a 5 gallon diesel tank.
Oh,
diesel container.
Yeah,
so I'm
going
to take the keys.
Oh,
but
yeah,
I'm not strong enough to stick a roof to them.
Really?
Oh. I'm going to empty about half of it.
Oh, wow.
So I asked my neighbor to give me a hand. Because half, 2.5 gallons I can lift, no problem.
Yeah.
But I know if I try it, I'll spill some of the bitch all over the place.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, the 5, you know, that's a pretty big.
Oh, yeah.
It's a big bucket.
Yeah, it's yellow. And I bought the proper container and everything.
Yeah, yeah.
Because, you know, it's clean. But the fun part behind it is that I love driving diesel.
Yes.
I think it's a beautiful animal. But by what I saw in the States, so that's why I wanted to take some diesel fuel with me,
mm-hmm,
to top up the tank every once in a while.
Yeah.
Because apparently they use too much bio in the States.
Oh yeah, there are some states, yeah, some states use more than others.
Yeah?
Yes.
But not in the northern part, I don't think. Because it's cold.
Well, I know they use it up in Wisconsin.
Oh yeah, well, yeah, yeah, but it's warmer down there than it is here.
Because a little bit, yeah.
Here, minus 40 is not unheard of.
No, exactly, yeah. That's
like
normal.
Minus 20 to minus 30 in the winter.
Yeah.
And then you gel up pretty good. But this thing here has never gelled up on me or anything like that. But it's something I said to my daughter when she bought that. And one day she sent me to start it. Maybe the first year she had it in the winter. And I started it. And within a minute, I had to.
You have what?
Heat.
Oh, heat. Oh, yeah.
Now go figure this one out. You know, my diesel, GMC diesel, 6.2
liter,
and
that's what
you have to warm up for, you know?
10 minutes,
15
minutes.
Uh-huh. Yeah. 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 So I tested it last winter. For example, you get heat and that thing like
that. Oh, wow. That's good.
And then I've been trying to read on it, but what she did, little brother, she took all the manuals and cursed them.
Oh, no.
I'm trying to find them. I didn't put any two of my butts for a set of manuals.
No.
So I got them on the internet. I downloaded them.
Yeah.
And if I had a good printer, I would print them. It's 100 pages of things. Matters not. As long as you have printed once, then you can refer to it, right? Go in there. So, one thing leads to another, but I just love that diesel. That,
everybody's looking at the camera today.
That's like over there?
They were looking over there, and the guys behind us were all looking at them.
That's okay. And that's what I got to do. I bought the micro SDS.
Oh, yes, yeah.
I got five of them.
Oh, wow.
Well, you know where you buy them that cheap and good?
I know you can get them cheap on eBay.
No? Go to Costco.
Really?
$29 in Canada.
Really? Yeah. What kind of part is it?
I'll show you. The, what's the brand name that the top brand name is? See, the thing is, it's cool.
They got
SanDisk.
Yeah, SanDisk.
That's the ones I bought.
Oh, okay.
And they, I don't want to throw numbers at you because of the program.
Yeah.
But there's two sides. That's the data transfer.
Yes.
Why pay $68 for something that does not even transfer at that rate that they claim? Right? Yeah. You transfer at a lower rate.
Yeah.
We all do. Yeah, at a lower rate. So, I think it's $30.
What kind of cards did you get? You get the extreme or you just get a traditional?
Traditional. Mm-hmm. And I know the, and it looks like a charm.
Yeah.
Right?
See, for videoing, like for a high quality camera like this, you want to go with a high rate. Because they, if you go with a slow rate, I notice it on the transfer rate on my computer. I have a slower rate one that only transfers 20 MB per second. And this one that I got in here transfers 60 MB per second.
That's it. Okay, these are the numbers.
Yeah.
But
they claim this one is supposed to do 90. I've never seen 90.
Yeah.
But 60 is a lot better than 20.
Because on my Mac, when I put this in my Mac,
yeah.
But you connect your camera to your computer, right?
No, I take the card out.
Card out, you put it into a little
holder. Yeah.
But have you got a Mac?
No.
No?
No.
Okay. So because when I put that card in mine, and I have to download a program, a converter. Because I have a Garmin, and it creates a, it's called EVI.
EVI.
Okay. And you put it to an MP4, I think.
Yes, you have to download a converter. Yeah.
Converter, put it there, manipulate, and then transfer it to iMovie.
Yes.
And this thing takes minutes.
Yeah.
But it's a pain in the ass because there are three minutes, 41 seconds.
Yeah.
Because I set it up a similar way.
Oh, okay.
What's the higher rate? 1080?
The highest rate right now going is 4K, and then there's 2K, and there's 1440p, and then 1080p.
Okay, 1080, okay. If I put it at that, it fills up the
control. Oh, yeah, in no time, yeah.
Right. And this is supposed to be, I thought it was 3 hours and 41 minutes.
Okay.
It's not. It's 3 minutes and 41 seconds. In segments.
Oh, yeah, in segments. Yes. But the total length of all the videos will be 3 hours.
So that's why I bought five cards.
Oh.
One of them I cannot. I should have lent it to you. I should have brought it to you and bring it back to me without erasing it. It's me and a friend going with a pair
Yes, you told me pictures last week, right? The week before, yeah?
Yeah, I sent you the picture of the car, right?
No, you showed me them. You just showed me them. Right?
I should send you the... But anyway, I have the video, and I'm trying to view it, you know, to transfer it, put it on the CD.
Yeah. Well, I should do that for you.
And take the sum out of it.
Yeah.
Because the thing is, I don't want it to go...
Yeah,
if you're in Calgary on the 5th of September,
okay,
right down the street here, yeah, that car's going to be there. There's a big show there, showing shine. Mm-hmm. I'll send you the information if you happen to be in Calgary. Right there. And the Panthera's going to be there. He was telling me there's 10 of them in Calgary.
Really?
Yeah, 10 Panthera in Calgary. Only two are being driven as day drivers.
I believe that.
I drive it, but I didn't fly into one. Look at it as a garage.
No kidding.
He drives it, and he drives it.
Yeah, I believe it.
Oh, man. And he's no spring chicken either.
You told me last week, yeah.
Actually, to be honest, he scared the shit out of me. Not that he was doing crazy things, but just the sheer speed in the traffic. I felt comfortable.
Yeah.
But the excited level was way up.
Yeah. That's crazy.
It was totally amazing. I just enjoyed it. And the guy, I'm just dying to go see it again.
But it is, you know, you're a general that's going, you know, when you drive.
Hey, the other thing is inverter.
Oh, yes.
I want to buy myself an inverter.
Okay.
Because for my car, believe it or not, I have an air mattress. And I've got an electric pump.
Oh, yeah.
And the thing is, in fact, you find out how many amps or watts that thing needs. Mm-hmm. And what is the best, where is the best to buy the inverter at? In Canada or in the States?
If you want to get a good inverter, that's the thing. If you want to get a good inverter, get a Cobra. Cobra is the best.
Okay.
All the inverters will say a number on it, how many watts they can produce.
Yeah.
99% of them that are out there do not produce that continuously. Cobra does.
Oh yeah.
So you got to look for that.
Uh-huh.
And Cobra is the top of the line. You can get a Canadian Tire one. They have enough Canadian Tire. But you got to read the box and you got to look to see what the wattage says for continuously.
Continuous output.
Yeah, continuous output. So that's what you got.
I better write that down because
I'm terrible at remembering stuff too.
Oh, geez, it's a sign of age, you know that.
I used to remember phone numbers. That's long gone.
Well, so do I. I used to be known at work as the savant of numbers. I would memorize IP address.
Oh, wow.
You'd walk up to a printer and say, what's the IP address of this one? I would tell you.
No.
Put it in, you'll find out.
Oh, wow.
I don't know why. Phone number. That's what I work with.
Yeah.
You know, like
numbers.
Database and physician database, all that demographics.
Yes, you told me that. Yeah.
And then, you know, that's the thing for you. My wife says, you know, she'll come up and say, what's so and so doing? And I would tell her, friends of ours, she doesn't remember my dude.
That's how I used to be too, but. But anyways, I know most of the truck stops they sell these yellow ones for the shoulder and body.
I was looking in here.
Both ones that they sell in here, don't buy.
About 3 or 4 months ago, I was here looking at that on purchase.
Yeah, don't buy.
I found the best place to buy garbage for my car. I got multiple things like the cell phone. the Garmin, the GPS, my little battery reader. Yeah. I got this little thing, and AutoZone.
Oh yeah, AutoZone. Yeah. Yeah.
And I was looking at that, the same thing here. The price was $30 for it here, and over there was $19.
Now the truck stuff, you gotta remember, they jack it up because they know truckers can't go really nowhere else.
That's right, well, the captive audience.
Yeah. But the Canadian Tire ones are pretty good too. I got a Canadian Tire one in my truck, and it's been in there now probably 4 years, uh-huh. and it's still working. But I mean, that's a big one, you know, it's a 1750, you know.
I don't need
You don't need that. You know, if you go with a
700, for
depending on what do you want to run. You just want that thing to fill up your
yeah.
I think you should be all right with a 500 or 600, if it's a continuous one.
Yeah. I'm going to check what that thing needs also.
Yeah.
And because what I want to do is I want to go fishing.
Mm-hmm.
And where I go is just north of Calgary by Innisfail.
Oh, yeah.
I go west of Innisfail. There's beautiful fishing spots on there.
Yeah.
So I just want to stay overnight.
Yeah.
And it's in the bush. Nobody knows you're there.
Yeah.
Cost you nothing. It's
nice, yeah.
Because here in Alberta now, it's everywhere with the dollars. And I mean, it's freaking expensive. I couldn't believe the cost.
Uh-huh. Thank you. You're welcome. Don't ask why they plated your food.
Oh, they do that all the time.
I know, I don't get it. We need bigger plates for the T-bone.
Yeah, they do. Could you get me more coffee and peanut butter and give me about a few strawberry jams to three or four?
Uh-huh.
No, we won.
That's right. Yeah.
Anyways, guys, we're fixing to have some lunch here, me and JP, so we will get to eating here and then we'll be right back.